To him. And then Paul the apostle said, do you have any other father? Do you have any other mentor? Do you have any other leader? And do you have any other person to challenge your faith and make you grow? Thou therefore, my son. Paul was talking to Timothy, be strong in the grace that is in Christ Jesus. But then Timothy was told to do another thing. You have learned something, pass it on. You've got something, give it out. And you have been disciple all the people in verse 2. And the things which thou hast heard of me among many witnesses. That's why we know that Paul the apostle concentrated on training people among many witnesses. He trained others also. Not only Timothy, he trained Timothy. He trained Titus, he trained Epaphroditus, he trained Onesimus, he trained quite a lot of people. You had this, Timothy, while I was training you, I was training other people too. And then he said among other witnesses, the same commit thou to faithful men. As I looked for you, and I sought you out, and I picked you up, and you were circumcised, and then I started training you, look for other people too. That's what we are saying. If you are a coordinator, have you always taught another coordinator? If you are a group coordinator, are you raising up another group coordinator? If you are a pastor, are you raising up another pastor? Or if you are a woman leader, are you raising up another woman leader? If you are a woman representative, are you raising up out of those women that are leading us fellowship, are you raising up other women representatives too? If whatever you know, are you passing on? Are you developing others? Are you discipling others? Are you encouraging others? Are you edifying others? Are you training other people? The things that thou hast heard of me among many witnesses, the same. Commit thou to faithful men who shall be able to teach others also. Who shall be able to teach others also? It shall never be heard that you are a coordinator, and then we have a nearby district now. We need a coordinator there, and we say, can you give us somebody that we are going to appoint there to be a coordinator? We don't have anybody. Why don't we have anybody? Be like Paul the apostle, pass it on to Timothy. And be like Timothy, pass it on to other people. The things that you have learned, you pass on to other people too. Actually, to show that you are a good leader, everything you know, you pour out to other people. It is when you do that and other people are being encouraged, they are being lifted up there, and they are being put in ministry. That's when you are successful as a leader. And this Timothy actually, he became such a leader that he was commended by other people and recommended to other people. In 1 Thessalonians chapter 3. We're reading there from verse 2. 1 Thessalonians chapter 3, we're looking at verse 2. And sent Timotheus, a brother and minister of God, and a fellow laborer in the gospel of Christ, to establish you and to comfort you concerning your faith. And you see, when Paul the apostle met Timothy, he was just a believer, just a disciple. Who are you, Timothy? I believe in the Lord Jesus Christ. I'm born again. That's what all it was. Who are you, Timothy? I'm just a disciple. I go to church and learn. A disciple is a learner. Now that you have come to know Paul the apostle, who are you now? I've gone beyond just ordinary believer. I've gone beyond just being a learner, a disciple. Who are you now? Well, I'm still a child of God, a brother. A brother to Paul the apostle, and a brother to the rest of the believers. And I'm now a minister of God, and then fellow laborer in the gospel of Christ. What can you do now? I can get the churches established as Paul the apostle is getting them established. And that's the growth in ministry. That's the growth in your lifestyle. That you are not just a brother, you're a minister of God. You're not just a minister of God, a fellow laborer in the gospel of Christ, to establish the Thessalonians and to comfort them concerning their faith. And that's what the Lord is expecting that we will do. And we will do that in Jesus' name. And if you've been coming to the church how many years now? 3 years. You cannot lead us worship after 3 years. And you'll be coming to the church for 5 years, 6 years, and you cannot lead a zone after 5 years? Is it that something is wrong with the coordinators or with the zonal leaders or with you, and that you are not coming up? And Paul the apostle is willing to take you, and is saying, Don't just sit down there. You can do more than you are doing. You can do more than just attending our fellowship. You can be a leader yourself. Because that's the reason we are there as Paul, as Peter, as John, as the apostles of the Lord, as the leaders in the church. It is to raise up other people. And we must give priority. Priority. That is, we give it number one place. And we give it a very heart, a very attention, and we give it all that we have got to be able to train other people like Timothy and Titus and many other people. I want you to look at Ephesians chapter 4. Ephesians chapter 4, I'm reading from verse 11, and it gives some apostles, and some prophets, and some evangelists, and some pastors and teachers. Why? That's why there's no full stop after verse 11. He gave us to be leaders so that something else may happen. Verse 12, for the perfecting of the saints. Have you ever sat back to think, why are you a coordinator? Well, I'm to preach in the district. That is more than that. I'm to supervise. It's more than that. It is for the perfecting of the saints, the equipping of the saints, the encouragement of the saints, and the lifting up of the saints, and the maturing of the saints, which were to be involved in raising up other people for the perfection of the saints, for the work of the ministry. We want to help other people to know how to do what they ought to do, and for the defining of the body of Christ. And then it says, till we all come in the unity of the faith and of the knowledge of the Son of God unto the perfect man, unto the measure of the stature of the fullness of Christ, that we henceforth be no more children. Well, we leaders, that the members of the church will be no more children. Children that can carry no weight. Children that can do nothing. Children that are just there to eat and to sleep, that we be no more children, and children that can easily be, you know, diverted and deceived and distracted, that the members of the church will no more be children, that when you are not there, they know what to do. That you, they can preach, and that you, they can stand for the truth, and that you, they can stand uncompromisingly for the unchanging, unadulterated word of God. That's the reason why we're leaders. It says to welcome in the unity of the faith, so that we'll henceforth be no more children tossed to and fro and carried about with every wind of doctrine by the sleight of men and cunning craftiness whereby they lie in wait to deceive, or to perfect the saints. That's why the Lord has called us, and that's why we're leaders. Let's look at Colossians chapter 1. In Colossians chapter 1, I'm reading from verse 28, who will preach one in every man. I'm teaching every man in all wisdom, that we may present every man perfect in Christ Jesus. I want you to notice in that verse 28, how many times the words every man, every man, every man, how many times those words come up. And then it makes you to understand what we're supposed to do. You are the Paul in that situation there, if you're a leader. And then there are many Timothys over there. And there are many sisters over there. What are we to do? Look at verse 28 again. We will preach, warning every man. We're preaching to every man. And we're not kind of neglecting, overlooking some people. There may be some people, though, they are not available like Timothy. And they are not approachable like Timothy. And if Paul, the apostle, will come to them and say, come over here, dear sister, come over here, dear brother, and you need to do more. It's like, you know, they want to shield themselves, protect themselves. And they don't want to be stretched. I'm okay what I'm doing. I don't want to be stretched. I'm alright the way I am. I don't want to be stretched. I've been leading us fellowship. I don't want to move from our fellowship to be a zona leader or to be a women rep. I'm okay the way I am. They don't want to be stretched, because stretching sometimes can cause pain. And stretching can cause inconvenience. And stretching may disturb you. You want to remain on the familiar ground where you have been.
That you have been blessed with this powerful message. Our address is at the bottom of the screen. I believe you will join us one of this Sunday to worship together. Thank you. God bless you. Let us pray. Our mighty Father, we glorify your name and thank you, Lord, because of this powerful message. I pray by the power in the blood of Jesus Christ, you will touch those people who are in need of salvation, those people who are in need of prosperity, those people who are in need of healing. And by the power in the blood of Jesus Christ, they will give testimony because of this message. In Jesus' name we pray. You are my God.
Say it one more time, say, oh, 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 Lord.